Hello and welcome to another accounting video. My name is Dr. Sharon Levin, and in today's lesson I'm going to help you to learn how to account for changes in accounting estimates. In this problem, on January the 1st, 2001, Philip Incorporated purchased a large walk-in refrigeration unit for his upscale restaurant in downtown Annapolis for $160,000. Philip Inc. estimates the refrigeration unit will last 8 years and have a salvage value of $10,000. Philip's CPA suggests using an accelerated method of depreciation called declining balance at twice the straight line rate, which is also known as the double declining balance method. Philip Inc. agreed. First, let's start to compute the depreciation. As a reminder, when using the double declining balance method of depreciation, salvage value is ignored in the computation of depreciation until the last year. The steps to determine the double declining rate: first, you need to determine the straight line rate of depreciation. To do so, you would take 100 divided by the number of years. So we have 100 divided by 8 years equals 12.5%. In other words, if we were going to use straight line depreciation on this asset, we would be depreciating the asset 12.5% every year for 8 years. But we're not. We're using the double declining balance method. So we're going to multiply 12.5 times 2, and we have the double declining rate is 25%. We have the cost of our asset is $160,000, which is also the book value at the beginning of the year. I've created a depreciation table here to help us stay organized. Notice it has the year. It has columns A, B, and C. And under each heading, you may see something in parentheses, which is telling you how to get the answer. So in this case, depreciation expense is computed by taking what's in column C, in other words, take this $160,000, and multiplying it times the double declining balance rate, which in this case is 25%. For column B, to get these answers here, you would take the sum of, I'm using the epsilon symbol to mean the sum of everything that's in column A. So $40,000, that's the only thing in column A so far at the end of 2000X1, so it's $40,000. When we get to the next year, you see that we have $40,000 plus $70,000, and therefore accumulated depreciation is the sum of everything in column A. Column C is the book value, and to compute the book value, you take what is in column C, for example, $160,000 at the beginning of the period, subtract out the accumulated depreciation of $40,000, and the new book value at the end of 2000X1 is $120,000. Again, the next period, 2000X2, we take $120,000, we multiply that times our double declining rate of 25%, and that gives us $30,000 of depreciation expense. When added to year one depreciation, we have accumulated depreciation of $70,000, and when we subtract $70,000 from the beginning of year book value, which was $120,000, we end up with $90,000. So I'm not going to go too slowly through the depreciation calculation because the goal of this problem is to help you learn how to compute changes in accounting estimates. But I wanted to give you a little bit of background on how to compute declining balance depreciation if you needed a reminder. Okay, now what happened? So 2 years have passed, and now we're in the third year. At the beginning of 2000X3, Philip Incorporated determines the refrigeration is not going to last 6 more years. So they change the remaining years of useful life to 4 years. Okay, so 2 years have passed. We had an original useful life of 8 years. But after 2 years, we determined that this refrigeration unit, it's unlikely to be able to last 6 more years. So we change our estimate and say that from now moving forward, the refrigeration unit will last an additional 4 years from the beginning of 2003. So in total, it will last the 2 years that we've already recorded plus 4 more years. So a 6-year useful life is now what we're expecting, but 2 years we've already recorded. So how do you record this change in accounting estimate? The first step is to compute the book value of the asset at the moment that the change was determined, that you're going to make the change. Notice that it's $90,000, and that figure comes from in this table. So we've already computed the $90,000, which is the book value at the end of 2000X2, and therefore it is also the book value at the beginning of 2000X3. That's where that number comes from. Now I need to recompute the straight line rate. Again, it's going to be 100 divided by the number of years remaining. So we have 100 divided by 4 years is 25% per year. For the straight line rate, we need to multiply that by 2 to get the double declining balance rate. So that is 50%. So now I'm going to unhide the table here, the rest of the table. And so you can see in 2000X3, the new equation, if you're familiar with Excel, you can look up in the formula bar to see that this formula was computed by taking what was in cell C21, and which is $90,000, and we multiply that times the double declining balance rate, which is 50% right here, and we come up with $45,000. Up here in the heading, I think I'm going to change this. I had originally had column C times the double declining balance rate of 25%. That was accurate until the change of estimate occurred, so I'm now going to take that out and just have it read column C times the double declining rate, which of course was, what was it in the beginning? It was 25% for the first 2 years, and for the last few years, it's going to be 50%. So now we have accumulated depreciation is the sum of everything in column A, and then of course the book value is $160,000 minus the accumulated depreciation. So we go through this iteration once again. How did I get that number? It's 45,000, the book value at the beginning of the period, times 50%. Add everything in column A to see what goes in the accumulated depreciation column, 137,500. And then I have a book value of 22,500, which is equal to 160,000 minus accumulated depreciation. The same calculation happens in 2005. Now we're in 2006. This is the year that the asset will stop being useful, and or we believe, I shouldn't say it'll stop being useful, we estimate that it will probably not be functioning too well, and maybe we need to either rehab it or replace it. So this is the end of its useful life after the estimate was changed. Notice earlier in the session here, I mentioned that as a reminder, when you're using the double declining balance method, or actually any declining balance method of depreciation, you ignore the salvage value in the computation of the depreciation until the final year. Remember I said that? I hope so. Okay, so here's the final year. What you do in the final year is you force the ending book value to be worth the salvage value. In other words, you can never depreciate into or beyond its salvage value. So I don't want to have a value of zero here because I do have a salvage value of $10,000, which was given in the problem. So in order to force this to be 10,000, I plug that number in, 10,000, no formula. Everything else in this column is computed using a formula, but when I get to the final year, I plug in my $10,000, that is my ending. In order to do so, what do I need to do to get this to be 10,000? Well, I look at the previous book value in the previous year. It's 11,250. So I realize that I need to subtract 1,250 out. So I'm going to make the depreciation expense in the final year 1,250. In other words, I force fit, and I think I have that written over here. The ending book value must equal the salvage value. Thus, force fit the depreciation expense in the last year when using the declining balance depreciation method. So I forced it to be 1,250. When I add all of these figures up, it brings me total accumulated depreciation is $150,000. And if you remember from the very beginning, the cost of the asset was $160,000 and the salvage value is $10,000. Therefore, I can depreciate $150,000. That's the maximum that can be depreciated. So we have the maximum depreciation or accumulated depreciation of $150,000, and that leaves with an ending book value of $10,000, which again is the salvage value. Notice the cells here aren't used. I have them listed here because originally this asset had an 8-year life and it looked like we were going to need a table with 8 rows, so I put them in. But once we change the estimate, we determine that we're not going to have the assets estimated life at 8 years, we change it to a total of 6 years. This is an important note, and put that in bold for you. A change in accounting estimate is handled in the period in which the decision was made and all future periods after that, or all subsequent periods. In other words, you do not go back and change prior financial statements. You do not make any adjustment to the retained earnings account. You simply recompute the depreciation. The moment that you decide, or the company decides that they want to change the estimate, you recompute the annual depreciation amount and finish depreciating that asset until its final year, and then you're done. So you don't go back and restate anything. Okay, that's it. I hope this was a helpful video. If you have any questions and you happen to be in one of my accounting courses, please ask questions in class. I'm always happy to help you. Thanks, everybody. Bye-bye.